Sod's Law is a British culture axiom that if something can go wrong, it will. Sometimes also made to include that it will happen at the worst possible time. The phrase seems to be derived, at least in part, from the colloquialism an unlucky sod, a term for someone who has had some bad unlucky experience, and is usually used as a sympathetic reference to the person. An alternative expression, again in British culture, is hope for the best, expect the worst. Sod's Law carries a sense of being mocked by fate. The law is a true tribute to the infinite depth and complexity of the inherent negativity of the human race, and the truly held belief that anything at any point in time is mere seconds from being ballsed up. Who hasn't ever hit every red light when in a rush, headed to the beach on the one rainy day in July, or had wine thrown down a new shirt on a first date? Of course, life is full of ups and downs, but why does it appear to go totally wrong at the absolutely most inconvenient moment? There are a few examples that have legitimate scientific explanations and therefore legitimate scientific solutions. Knowledge is power, and once you know the cause of your seemingly terrible luck, you can use it to your advantage and once more become the master of your fate and the captain of your soul. It rains more on a weekend. Typical. You've been hunched over your fluorescent-lit desk all week trying to ignore the glare of the blazing hot sunshine that is bouncing off your screen and directly onto your retinas. Come Saturday morning, you throw open your curtains, ready to finally embrace the great outdoors, only to find that it's shutting it down and you've forgotten to bring the washing in. So why does it always appear to rain on the weekend? The simple answer is cloud seeding. During the week, tiny particles of dust and pollution called aerosols spew from cars and factories and float off into the atmosphere. These little bits of crud give the moisture in the air something to cling onto and begin a chain reaction that forms clouds. These accumulate and finally reach breaking point just as your weekly Saturday morning bowls club hit the green. There's an upside to the rather gloomy thought of polluted rain clouds. A surprising result of the study revealed that these weekly showers may take some of the cloud out of more serious storms and even hurricanes. Once you hit one red light, you will hit them all. There's no better feeling than the one you get as you sail through a string of green lights, especially if they turn red just as you clear them. Unfortunately, this usually happens when you have all the time in the world to reach your destination. It's at 8:55 a.m. when you've got your shirt on inside out and you've left the house half an hour late because a cat threw up on your kid's bed, that you find yourself sat at one red light after another with your blood pressure reaching boiling point. No, this isn't just because you forgot to make a sacrifice to the god of traffic lights. It's probably at least partly to do with the fact that you're late in the first place. Traffic management is a very subtle art, some might even say witchcraft, and sequencing traffic lights is a real balancing act. On a section of road with a big long string of traffic lights, they will probably all be set on a similar repeating cycle, let's say 2 minutes. This cycle is designed to keep traffic flow moving steadily through. However, they calculate this based on the naive assumption that everybody is going to be sticking to the speed limit and driving in a nice, calm fashion. So when you go speeding through because you're late and stressed, you throw those careful calculations right out the window. Whatever can go wrong will go wrong, and at the worst possible time. Most people will recognize this form as irony, as one of the most often used in informal speech, writing, and media. As a consequence, it also happens to be the most often misused form of irony. It's pretty much akin to throwing one's arms in the air and shouting, "The universe is against me." Feel free to do that, by the way. The idea is that no matter how hard you try, at the worst possible occasion in which something could actually go wrong, it will, in the most unforeseen way and with the most tragic circumstances. For example, Sod's Law is exactly the Alanis Morissette situation. Americans will recognize the phenomena of going on holiday to Spain for the gorgeously hot weather, only for it to rain the whole time. And when they get back, they find out it's been the hottest fortnight since the records began. Bad luck at its best. Sod's Law itself is a product of humanity's natural predisposition to the negative. You'd probably never give your boiler a second thought until it breaks during a cold snap. Or remember the time you walked through your living room without stubbing your toe. Unless you're doing that a lot, in which case it might be time for some feng shui. Hundreds of studies have confirmed that humans have a hardwired negativity bias that is nigh on impossible to shake, no matter how sunny the disposition. We process negative experiences much faster than positive ones. Tests have shown that from a very early age that we're much better at picking out an angry face in the crowd than a happy one, and we're much more likely to remember an experience that caused us pain or discomfort. When you put it like that, it's easy to see how these traits could have been advantageous to us in an evolutionary context. Would it benefit us more to quickly recognize the placid gaze of a passing deer or the cold, calculating eyes of a tiger crouched in the grass next to it? Now that we, for the large part, no longer have to contend with tiger attacks on a daily basis, this negativity bias is channeled into convincing yourself that the universe is punishing you via the medium of traffic lights. So lighten up a bit, will you? I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel Explified to watch more such videos.